Hello and welcome to another, Random Battle Replay cast. And first, I want to apologize for not uploading that frequently. Recently, I was on a business trip last week and barely had any time since I was 4 days away, and then the weekend was just to relax, and I had also some events going on there. But yeah, here we are again, and that's a game I played with Sturf from my clan and Slenderman, one of my mods from my Discord, on the weekend, I think it was Sunday, and we had a pretty tough game to master, let's put it like this. And there are two CVs on each side involved, which is always not really comfortable. Mogami, the ship that I'm playing here right now, is definitely not known for having a strong AA. I have defensive AA equipped, besides the fighter plane, to have an additional help against enemy attacks, but only 3 consumables of each, which doesn't last very long if the game goes very long. For those who are interested, I'm running the 155mm Mogami guns, and I have IFHE on my captain to increase the damage and to be able to pen the 32mm threshold. Of course, if you're playing Mogami, you should be aware that everybody is shooting at you, no matter if you're angled or not. Especially the battleships love to farm you. So, in the start of the game, it's recommended to play passive. Always have an eye on where the enemy battleships are, and probably try more to dodge than to angle. I think that's the best thing you can do. Apart from that, maybe I should also mention that I'm running the double rudder shift module, especially in tier 10 games when you need this evading capabilities even more, because angling is not a matter there anymore. Then this becomes really helpful. And again, shooting at me as usual. Alright, but on the other hand, Mogami is very squishy, but it has also really great damage output with these guns. Ah, excuse me, guys. Yeah, also on top, let's talk a bit about the carriers, a nuisance that we all love. You see that guy in the chat, this Suriyana Captain Katsurada. He is like completely playing Shokako, has of course AP bombs, which means that he can devastate cruisers pretty easily with these. And as you just saw, that Atago got reduced his health from full HP to 1/3 HP. So this is of course dangerous, that guy, and he seems to be a bit full of himself. I mean, if you look, Atago was in the AA bubble of myself, of the North Carolina that is played by Sturf, and herself, and still he got completely wrecked there. Sad part, but that's how it is, at the moment at least. I assume that Wargaming will change certain things regarding the carriers or the AA soon. Since we have a destroyer in this game, the Lightning from Slenderman in our division. Of course, we have some kind of control over this cap. We don't need to play aggressive right now. The Lightning has the advantage that he can always disengage with the smoke, so he is not in really big danger from the CV right now. And he is able to cap, which is even better. Then we have an Asashio on this flank, which is of course a big problem for Sturf in the North Carolina. And he also pinged, I think, or I know that the Asashio is here, or I can remember that he was here, and Lightning is already pushing this. So we need to get rid of him, because otherwise our battleship is in constant danger of getting torped. And there we go, he already ate some. But yeah, so this is the battle, how it's going on, and right now we secured A, which is good. And now we just need to wait for the enemy to push, because that's the whole reason of it. And then you can farm the damage, and that's good. On the other flank, it doesn't look too great. I mean, most of the ships are heading towards us right now. And left over is Graf Spee, New Orleans, our Shokaku, which is sleeping really well. Because you should be aware in a carrier, if you play it, that if the enemy is that close, you have only these amount of ships left, you should bail immediately. So he should already be on this side. I don't know why the Saipan is going towards this side, which makes doesn't make any sense either. But I think our carriers are a bit occupied. I can tell you so much, they are not the brightest when it comes to that. In terms of positioning and having the awareness when to go where. Alright, as we all see, the enemy is pushing into D. And the enemy carriers are harassing the New Mexico and Graf Spee, who are leftovers at D. Both tier 6 against tier 8 carriers, that's gonna be no fun, and I assume sooner or later they will die. That brings trouble for our team, or a lot of trouble, because then it looks really grim. And Sturf and myself, we are already heading towards the other side, while Slenderman in the Lightning stays at the A cap. Just for the reason to like delay the push, because the push will come. They have 1, 2, 3 battleships plus a Helena, probably carrier support, so it's gonna be rough. But if 1, 2, 3 ships, 2 cruisers and a DD are staying here, that should be okay. We need to fight back these cruisers here. Cleveland, Charmatel, Miyoko, and an Ismail is on the D flank. So seeing that is really important. Yeah, I'm pummeling this Helena who is sitting behind the island, but I'm able to lob shells over it. But so far, not too much happening. Yeah, don't shoot here, I wait until I'm shortly behind the island. Always keeping some distance to the island so I have space to maneuver into this island in terms I'm getting shot at. And so I can use the island to turn out again. So it's a really important thing you should be aware of. I intentionally damage count here, even though it wouldn't have been necessary. But I knew that I will be safe behind this island, so I'm starting to farm a bit while I'm still slowly moving towards this area. Yeah, that NC has no fun. 7 HE hits, all penetrate. It can be annoying. And yeah, shooting my guns on the retreating path. Here was a miscommunication. I said to Slenderman he should stay here at A. Our Tirpitz is pushing in, which is not recommended, but gives us a lot of spotting, which is also okay, and a lot of distractions. And as mentioned, these ships died, the Shokaku died, and yeah, now it looks very grim, and we have to really fight. Changing my angles where to shoot on the Cleveland. I can easily kite the Cleveland. If he's starting to shoot on this ranges, I have an easy time versus him. Charmatel is a different story, but if he's that far away, my shells won't hit him accurately, but the Cleveland on 14 kilometers, 13 kilometers, I'm able to hit reliably. And he realizes this and goes dark, which is a smart move to do. In a Cleveland versus cruisers, you want to open up closer distances, because as soon as you start to shoot kiting cruisers, so-called kiting cruisers, which the Mogami is, you have troubles. Yeah, also I have not the biggest range with 15.7. And now I have to watch out what this Charmatel is doing. He's already opening fire, so I have to turn away, because otherwise I'm running into a crossfire. I mean, not really a crossfire. I mean, AP from the Cleveland lead range is not really scary, but AP of a Sharma tablet reload booster can be very scary. So I'm angling northwards, keeping my angle towards the Charmatel, hope that Sturf is shooting him, and yeah, pummel the Cleveland even more. CV is going for me using fighter plane plus defensive that helped out and killed the Enterprise torpedo dive bombers completely. Yeah, Sturf had fun with the Charmatel, it looks like. And also Slenderman is about to finish him, it looks like. Yep, torpedo, finish him off. The Chicago didn't go for me, which is interesting. I expected that he would do that, so. But yeah, so for now we stalled the enemy a bit, but of course the carriers are a problem. Because our Saipan also managed to die, because he continued to sail that way, and yeah, normally that's game. If the enemy are somewhat decent, they will just kill us all. Sturf under heavy pressure here as well. He won't survive that for sure. He said at least that he won't survive. I'm already getting in a kiting position. First, I want to get rid of this North Carolina. We need to secure two caps. That's really important. Slenderman is already back there, and now I'm focusing the North Carolina with the intention to kill him as quick as possible, and on top then just turning around to handle the Cleveland and the Ismail together. It's anyways a real rough uphill fight, and at that point usually, I mean, that Chicago showed that he knows how to drop, for example, so we know that we are in constant danger. I have only one defensive A, one fighter plane consumable left, and again combined AA doesn't matter that New Mexico gets dropped. I mean, if you look at my damage counter here up in this area, 38,000 damaged planes, only 16 shot down, but that's a hell lot of planes. And Enterprise able to retreat. Yeah, that New Mexico made a big mistake. He just turned out the wrong time. Now he should angle away towards my position. But he still keeps sailing in a straight line. That gets you, of course, killed, especially with a ship like the Ismail. Chicago is going to attack me. I'm using always both consumables, not sure if that's the smartest move. Maybe you should only use one consumable, because the dive bombers of the Chicago are more dangerous than the actual torpedo bombers. I tried to help out, but that's really not recommended in this with these carriers. If you try help out your teammates, normally you lack, especially in prolonged games and you don't have superintendent, you lack the defensive AA consumable or fighter plane consumable, and you can't protect yourself then anymore. Launching some preemptive torps, don't expect them to hit, but you never know. And start to pummel this Ismail. Of course he has the new damage con, or the different damage con consumable, and he's able to hit all on my stern, which is of course super annoying. And now the Chicago dive bombers come in, and this is normally like that's game, because he can easily wreck me. The only thing I can do is just hoping that he's not really hitting that well, like this one. This was okay for me. I don't think that I dodged it, but okay. At least that carrier, the Chicago, is really full of himself, if you read the chat every now and then. It was pretty annoying. I mean, he knows that he's top tier, he's playing in kind of OP class kind of at the moment, and it's just like wrecking the people. There we go. That's half my HP of my remaining gone. But yeah. I have to live with it as long... It's just a fight of attrition here, more or less. And if you play Mogami, you want to dish out as much damage as you can in a time as quick as possible. You see me dodging here. I'm not worried about the Cleveland. Cleveland on this range, if you're dodging where your speed, direction and so on, he will have a hard time to hit you at all, even with good aim, because his shell travel time is way too long. So I want to get rid of this Ismail desperately, so I can use my broadside and shoot my broadside volleys on the Cleveland. Should be enough though for the Ismail. He has either no damage con available or already ran out of it, which is of course great for me. Yeah. Right, these bombers are killing me more or less. But I killed the Ismail in return. And hope to get rid of the Cleveland, which gives our team a lot of opportunities. Because if you look at the map, we have one Belfast surviving. Yeah, and there I'm going. But I'm able to take out that Cleveland, which is really important. But what went wrong here? Well, yeah, you see Mr. Fullhoof himself again in chat, like, announcing, yeah, whatever, I don't know if he was trolling or whatever, it was just simply annoying. But he forgot, totally forgot, that they don't have a cap, or that they don't have enough caps. We got already three now. Our lightning is heading towards B and the Belfast. If he's smart, he has still a smoke available and will just smoke up to survive, because now it's just about surviving. If we have all the caps, we will win this game. And I mean, if these enemy carriers weren't too greedy for damage and would go actually for the targets that would make sense, in this case our destroyer. Yeah, I'm telling you, Belfast, you smoke, but he already did that by himself. And now he's safe. Of course, the carriers are able to plant drop, but that's a... yeah, how can we say it? It's not so easy. Yeah, you saw the plant drop. Now my lightning spots the Enterprise and goes towards B. And as I said, the lightning has the good advantage that you can just sit in the smoke, wait out the carrier. If he tries to attack him, then the carrier can just drop the smoke if he wants to, and if he doesn't, well, then we get the cap. It's pretty simmy. Yeah, Stoff was really, really, really pissed off about this carrier, who was constantly like writing these messages in the chat. Like, as I said, full of himself. But at this point, we just overtake the enemy points, and yeah, and the enemy has no cap. And why is that? Because their carriers only cared about damage, which is necessarily not bad, but in these close games, you need to care about caps and points as well. And that's what they fail to understand. I mean, the Enterprise was making his way, let's be honest, but Shukaku, that big mouth Shukaku, never be seen here. I mean, we know almost the direction he's coming from. I think it was somewhere here. But he rather played it safe, right? Why bring in your HP if it's necessary, like this Enterprise does? Even if they attack the lightning now, it doesn't matter. Yep, trash talk all game and lose. There we go. We win the game. And there's a famous saying in English. Pride comes to a fall. And that was definitely the case here. And it was a very satisfactory win in the end. Not the highest damage numbers and so on. Doesn't matter, it was very satisfactory. If someone has such a big mouth and then just get like lost the game when there is barely any chance for our team to win it if they play it correctly. I checked his stats afterwards, and he has not even like 1,000 games. I mean, he seems to be decent in carriers, but yeah, I think you shouldn't like behave like this. That's not how you do it, in my opinion. Playing on an OP class, like annoy and make the ships suffer, and then all on top, even shit talking in chat, it's super annoying. Absolutely super annoying, and thus it's like, yeah. I wouldn't say fair or something like that, but that's, I mean, I think you know what I mean. Bad behavior. All right, we ended up in a nice base XP battle. Lightning got all the caps, I got plane kills and damage on several ships. Also shot down some planes, which is quite surprising in a Mogami. But yeah, also not too special. But yeah, as I said, very satisfying game that we had here. At least with the end result. Yeah, and that's it for today's episode. Hope you enjoyed it. Maybe you learned something from it. A game is won when it's won and not before. Shit talking doesn't pay off all the time. That's maybe what you should also not do. Yeah. So I release you with this video into the day, and yeah, have an enjoyable day. See you next time. Bye bye.